Come and we want to go home.
Daylight come and we want to go home.
Yeah.
He sponsored, chaperoned, and did wonders with Miriam McKellar. Uh-huh. We have been very, very richly blessed. We really are the beneficiaries of incredible, incredible loving Ingrid and Brand. Because, you see, he hasn't mentioned that under his guidance, Coca-Cola in South Africa did tremendous things. We had threatened that whatever you did, we were not going to back down on saying don't operate in South Africa. We told them that, give us the money, we want it. if we will say get out. And he supported something called the Equal Opportunities Foundation in our country, doing tremendous work. Supported my own ministry as Archbishop. And then, whilst I was on sabbatical, ensured that I had splendid support with John Allen, for whom they paid his salary during all of this period. So I am very, very richly blessed, and thank you very much. Thank you. It's not my foundation, actually. I mean, you know, it's all these people who have been mentioned, but it is just wonderful. And at the moment, with the rand being what it is, it means it's about seven million rand. I mean, you know, that really is a tiny sum. Friends, all of you who are here, but know that I mention each one of you in my heart. And as I'm the MC, and these people are worried about Robert, wonderful lady. He came to me as a young South African and said he didn't want to serve in the South African Defence Force. And again, because of this interconnectedness, I was able to ask Hayes Rockwell, was then rector of St. James, can you do something? And they did. And he's ended up as dean of St. Mark's in Seattle. We have been very, very, very richly blessed. And I thank each and every one of you most warmly, most fervently. In Atlanta, I have a rector, Buck. Where is Buck? Somewhere there, who's an incredible rector, very supportive of the South African. But so are all of you. I mean, you're not all rectors, but we are all supportive of what has been happening in our country. Thank you. Where is Danny?
Danny in the back.
Danny Glover. I thought I saw him. Yeah? Yes, and wonderful. You are all. All of you have been tremendous in the support you gave me in my ministry as Archbishop. And I've always said I would never have been able to do the things that I did without. In fact, if the truth be told, I am just a splendidly successful captain because I had such a superb team. It's the same on the TRC. They tend to give kudos to me. But I tell you quite honestly, I am the decoration. The people who did the work were people like Pete here, who were the TRC staff, TRC commissioners, TRC committee members. I was just good at being the captain. And you're always a good captain when your side is winning. And I've been fortunate to have such good team. All of you have been. I just wanted to say two last things. We are launching this Peace Center on the eve, is it? Yes, on the eve of June the 16th. June the 16th, 1976, happened when our young people said enough is enough. And South Africa was never to be the same again. And it is appropriate that we celebrate the wonderful idealism of those young people and of all young people. Sometimes, perhaps in this country, because of Columbine, because a 13-year-old shoots to death their teacher, there are those who tend to dismiss young people and are disillusioned with young people. I say no, 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 no. And I'm sure that you would want to say no, 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 no. They're not all the same. For we have had the privilege of meeting young people, say in Honduras, coming from affluent homes here, working as Peace Corps, others working in Habitat for Humanity, dreaming dreams of a different kind of world, idealistic. And one wants to say, hey, dream, dream. Go on and be idealistic. Don't allow the cynicism of such as ourselves to infect you. Dream, because God has the same dream. God has a dream of a new kind of world. God dreams that yes, my children one day are going to discover that they are my children, that they are members of family, that they are sisters and brothers, and therefore that it doesn't make sense. It is an obscenity that you can spend all of the amount of money on what they call budgets of defense when they are really budgets of death and destruction, knowing that just a small fraction would enable God's children everywhere to have clean water, to have enough to eat, to have a good education, to have a safe environment. That if we are family, we couldn't possibly tolerate those who live in the so-called third world groaning under the burden of unpayable debt. If we realize that we are family, and God says, you see, this family has no outsiders. They are all insiders. All belong, all. For you see, when Jesus said, if I be lifted up, will draw, he didn't say, I will draw some. He said, I will draw all, rich, poor, white, black, red, yellow, male, female, young, old, educated, not educated, beautiful, not so beautiful, all, lesbian, gay, straight, all belong, all. And you know that all includes Hitler, Mussolini, Amin. For God says, you know, hey, they are my children. And I would hope that one day they will discover that they are my children. and they will become all that I want them to become. You know that lovely story, it's an African story, of the farmer who had this strange looking bird in his backyard, and it behaved like a chicken. It was pecking away, but it did look funny, but they tolerated it until somebody smart in these things came along and said, "Hey man, that's not a chicken, that's an eagle." And the farmer says, "Twaddle, man. It's all baloney. This is a chicken. It behaves like a chicken. It eats grass and then, doesn't know that there is a blue sky overhead." And the man said, "Please, give it to me." And the farmer gave him this strange looking bird. And this man walks with the bird and climbs a tall mountain and waits for the sunrise. And then as the sun rises, this man turns the bird towards the sun and says, "Fly, eagle, fly." And the strange looking bird shakes itself, spreads its pinions, and lifts off. And it soars and soars and flies away and disappears into the distance towards the sun. And God says to us, "Hey, you are no chickens. You are eagles." And so God wants us to shake ourselves, spread out our pinions, and then lift off. For you know, we are made for goodness. We're made for beauty. We're made for the truth. We're made for transcendence. We're made for God. We're made for fellowship. We're made for togetherness. We're made for all the things that we know we long for so deeply. God says, go for it.
God Almighty, God above, oh please look down and see my people through, Lord of love, God Almighty, God above, oh please look down and see my people through. I believe that God put sun and moon up in the sky when the day is gray. I know it's just clouds passing by. The lilies of the valley, they neither toil nor spin. And springtime flow.